of monkey business can we expect when the new colobus are released onto their island home?
Four more colobus have arrived from France, taking the island's population up to seven.
Beautiful day, so today we will open the door and let them out and see what happens.
But is Half Mile Lake and the upgraded electric fencing enough to keep these acrobatic monkeys contained?
Any animal could probably swim if it really has to and needs to. With their leaping ability and the fact that it's all new and strange, that they may end up jumping in the water. But we're taking precautions.
While Mark mans the island, Matt and Amy will patrol the lake, armed with capture nets should any colobus brave the hippo-infested waters.
For this first couple of minutes, they'll be the vital one to making sure that they don't run straight off the edge of the island without realising that the land does stop.
Everyone's in position.
Yeah, we're ready.
The atmosphere's electric. The doors are locked and the colobus are released. Moving at up to 30 miles an hour and leaping up to 10 meters at a time, it's almost impossible to keep eyes on all seven as they rocket around the island.
Andy, if you go that way a little bit, because they've run behind that bamboo now.
Their meter-long tails help them balance on branches and act like parachutes as they leap down from trees.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Are they all still there, or has one escaped?
One went up and one was down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Fabulous.
I was a bit concerned that they just all panic, go straight over the edge, but they didn't. They were controlled and, you know, just explored.
The Magnificent Seven have arrived. So, how about Colobus Island? Though these residents are here to stay, I think this will always be Nico's Island.